when we talk about domain names and when you want to register domain name, with considering all this factor what I said, it's very challenging to find a single word domain name. Yeah, today finding a domain name has become very challenging. Try it out and you'll realize that so challenging. Milte nahi hai. So almost any domain name that you could think of would have been purchased or taken away. Okay, like moment abhi aap dabba ko kuch bole na, dabba service or whatever, dabba wala. Aap try kar lo, wo bhi shayad gaya hoga. Okay, nahi milega aapko domain name. Okay, so kehne ka matlab hai, this kind of domain names have become very rare and difficult to get. So let's see what are the options available. Option one is, what you should do is, you can club two words. What you should do is find the keywords of your business. Okay, describe and list down five words, the five keywords about a business, and then try to connote two words together. Yeah, compound these two words, join kar lo usko. Jaise, you know, fashion wear, okay, yaar, great deals, yeah, or ask Ganesha, Crick Info. Now, cricket information, uska short karke Crick Info. So, at least two words ko cart kut ke bhi agar jod ke agar kar sakte ho, then there's a very high possibility that at least you are within your domain name, within the meaning of the domain which you want to convey to the world, you may get a domain name for yourself. Option two is, you twist the word completely. So you twist the suffix or a prefix, I mean the beginning or the ending of the word. Okay. So let's take an example of Dynamics, Shopify, Timeify, okay, Explora, Stylo. Now style ka stylo kar diya, Shopee ka Shopify kar diya, Timeify kar diya. Isko yane apne jo suffix hai, ya, in short, twist the word. So kya hoga? You still want to own a word in customer's mind, you are closer to it, okay. But wo, agar, let's say I want a style. I want to own that word in customer's mind, but वो domain नहीं मिल रहा मुझे, उसको stylo कर दिया, ठीक है? या explore, I am in a travel business, I want to own the word explore, okay? But वो नहीं मिल रहा मुझे domain name, explore कर दिया, ठीक है? So that's one option. Option three is create abbreviation, okay? Now see example like OLX, it stands for online exchange, okay? Or silo. CYLO stands for called your loved ones, yeah, or MYOB stands for mind your own business. Yeah, sneaky baat nahi, it's a really a company called MYOB. In fact, MYOB is one of the most popular accounting software in Australia and New Zealand. What we have Tally in India is something similar MYOB in Australia, okay, and it's so popular that people don't say account there, people say MYOB ho gaya, have you done your MYOB? What it means, have you done accounting? Okay, so it's become so generic.
So like Google.
It's like Google, exactly, yeah. Okay, so now MYOB stands for mind your own business. Okay, it's an abbreviation.
When you said about MYOB, so there is a term called generalization of trademarks.
Yeah.
So like when we have certain, like if you see Google, we don't say now we want to search, we want
True.
To Google now.
True.
So how over the period of time it has been seen when the trademark becomes Google, generalized, yeah. It becomes difficult to protect those kind of trademarks.
No, trademarks, you will still go to trademark today itself, right?
Yeah.
And that's owned by you and it's protected.
No, okay. There are been cases where sometimes a generalized, like if we say fridge. So, fridge was a trademark once upon a time.
True. And same is for the Xerox.
Yeah. So, right. Now it has become so generalized so that anybody can use fridge and nobody can stop using that trademark too. So, that is how when the generalization impacts.
Yeah. So, agree. So, now that's something which you have to think and how you want to. But it takes long time to your word to become, your brand name to become generic. Okay, it's a long time. Okay, and today's world, if you recall my discussion in I think research and planning, that you know your business models are shrinking today. Okay, it's no more going to be 20 years or 30 years or 50 years. Yeah, 5 years, make your money and move into different business model or innovate further, and that time you may create some different brand altogether. Yeah. Anyway, your objective is not to make generic. It becomes generic, good for you. I mean, that means it has got a power that much.
Yeah.
Okay, but it's a long years it takes to become a generic. Okay, Google also has, Google introduced in 98 or I think, 97, yeah. So, kitne saal ho gaye? almost 19 years now. Yeah, and now today we say Google Karlo. Okay, so it takes long years for word to become or a brand name to become generic. All right, so coming back to a point of so create an abbreviation. अगर आपको नहीं मिलते word, तो this is one more option I'm just planting in your mind. Okay. के यू कैन ट्राई टू कम अप विथ एन एब्रीवेशन एंड क्रिएट अ न्यू वर्ड फॉर योर सेल्फ. ओके, द एडवांटेज इज यू आर क्रिएटिंग एन कंप्लीट न्यू ब्रांड, अ न्यू वर्ड. ओके, यू आर कॉइनिंग अ न्यू वर्ड. ओके, एंड येट इट इज मीनिंगफुल फॉर द कस्टमर. ओके, इज नथिंग समथिंग विच इज आउट ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. लाइक मिंत्रा हैज गॉट नो मीनिंग, या बट वेन यू से साइलो एंड इफ आई टेल एक्सप्लेन माई कस्टमर, इट मीन्स कॉल योर लव्ड वंस, तो मुँह पे स्माइल रहती है. हाँ, कुछ यू नो, इट मेक्स रियली मीनिंगफुल फॉर कस्टमर. या or you can create an abbreviation out of a pronunciation. Yeah, now just see this, read these first three letters. What does it read like? I, it reads like I seek you, right? It reads as I seek you, right? So it's a out of pronunciation they are trying to create a name. Or we ideate, V-I-D-8. It's pronounced as we ideate. Or appliance, pronounced as appliance. Right? So this is also a new innovative way to create a brand or a name for yourself. And it makes very interesting for people. Yeah. Again, it creates a new word, completely new word, no, not a dictionary word. So it becomes brandable. And yet it becomes very interesting for people. Of course, it requires explanation. If I just say ICQ, people don't understand. If I just say appliance, people don't understand. But then you explain it stands for appliance, and मुँह पे स्माइल आती है लोगों के. हाँ यार, क्या intelligent है, right? So you can create. Of course, here in this case, very very challenging to get a proper pronunciation, because English की pronunciation आप change नहीं कर सकते हो. Okay, तो proper combination मिलना is a challenge. लेकिन मिल गया अगर आपको, so I think you should register, it's interesting. Option 5 is to repeat a word. Agar aapko ek word nahi milta, to usko repeat kar do. So talk talk, bye bye, tom tom, food food, po po. So ye kya hota hai, ise you know, it becomes very playful on your mouth. When you have a rhetoric, it gives a rhetoric to the word, to your brand. Okay, so if I say talk talk, okay, it becomes very playful on the tongue. Yeah, and people generally tend to remember this such kind of brands easily. Yaad reh jate hain. And we have a habit, you know, hum bolte na roti choti khali kya. Huh? So that's the way we talk. It's something which we are wired to speak that way. Okay, so even a brand name with such repeat words becomes helpful. People tend to remember and becomes very playful on the mouth. Yeah. एंड नेम शुड बी सच. आई ऑलवेज बिलीव दैट नाम ऐसे होना चाहिए कि उच्चार में लोगों को ईजी होना चाहिए, आसान होना चाहिए, एंड दे शुड बी इट शुड बी प्लेफुल. या ऑप्शन 6, क्रिएट अ शॉर्ट फ्रेज लाइक बुक माई शो, ऑल फॉर सेल, मेक फॉर मी, मेक माई ट्रिप. नाउ दीज आर शॉर्ट फ्रेजेज. द चैलेंज इन दिस केस इज टू कीप योर डोमेन नेम्स विद इन 10 अल्फाबेट्स. I personally believe that your domain name should not be longer than 10 alphabets. It's not a rule. Your domain name could be as big as 256 characters. Okay, but 10 characters ke andar agar domain name aapka hai, to yaad rehne mein aasan ho jata hai logo ko. Agar lamba domain name hai, to it becomes difficult for people to remember. Option 7 nowadays, the new trend is to drop vowels. Now at times you may want to have that word, I don't want to compromise, lekin that word is not available. Okay, in such case then you drop a vowel. You know what is vowel? A, E, I, O, U. These 5 alphabets are vowel in English, we all know. Okay, so you drop it and still it pronounces the same way. So for example, quicker. Okay, now quicker mein E nikal liya, it still reads as quicker. Or flicker, unboxed, savan. Alright, so you can drop a vowel and try to get a domain name for yourself. Yeah. Option 8 is coin a completely new word. Ek din baith jao bathroom mein 2 ghante pen aur paper lekar, बाहर बोर्ड लगा दो, डू नॉट डिस्टर्ब, ओके, एंड देन बैठ के जितने वर्ड आपको लगते हैं यू कैन क्रिएट, क्रिएट अ वर्ड, एंड आई एडवोकेट दिस ऑप्शन, क्रिएट अ कंप्लीटली न्यू ब्रांड फॉर योरसेल्फ, इट कीप्स अवे फ्रॉम योर कॉम्पिटिशन एंड पीपल टेंड टू रिमेंबर न्यू ब्रांड्स इजिली. Of course, in the sense, even abbreviation, which I told you, it in a way, it's a coining a new word. If you can do abbreviation like OLX, it's a new word, but it also stands for online exchange. No, then that is something more better.
Actually, Google has a meaning. So they have taken it from that literal meaning. It actually means one followed by 100 zeros.
Sir, which Google is, was a mistake. If
you was know. Technically huh? in...
Yeah, exactly.
That's what one is? Followed by 100 zeros. Yeah, so they have yeah. shifted the word. One of the things that they do in the logo in terms of its representation is show a lot of zeros somewhere.
True.
So they have actually twisted the word, but they have taken it from there. So it's a twist, just to share.
No, sorry, it was a mistake. You don't even know.
Then possibly.
Yeah. Okay. So Google. I'll tell you what the story. If you know Google, so they were to register Google, like what you said. Okay, that's true. And when they went in registration, register galti se ho gaya G-O-G-L-E. Okay. And that mistake, whatever it was, okay, now if you're a numerist or numerologist or whatever it is, but their luck was good, it worked. And Google is the history. So if you search online and Google ki khud ki story padh lo aap, so they have mentioned that it was a mistake actually. Registration karte time galti ho gayi spelling ki, or then register ho gaya to theek abhi ye ho gaya to ye rakh lete hai. Okay, it was God gift. Or today Google has. So kahi bar kahi galti mistake hoti hai, lekin it is good mistake they did. Today, you know, you can't decide a company name and then look for a domain name. You have to first look for a domain name, or jo mila, then you decide a company name. Okay, so it's like that. All right. So Springer, Nexter. Are Nexter me? Ha, Nexter is a new word. Yahoo, Google. Okay. Jabong is people say Jabong also, but Jabong is a South African flower. There's a flower in South Africa which is called Jabong. New trend today is also to use a vernacular language. Okay, so shadi.com, makan, dukan, naukri, mano to jano, gana, MRP se kam. Okay, now, kahi bar kya hota hai? Ek to ye words easily available hai, comparatively. Secondly, these are good for India-centric sites. People in India at least can relate to that sites. And third, even if your customers are global, for them it becomes a brand name. Right? Agar, like for example, Savan, ya gana. We understand what is Ghana here. For them, it's a brand name. It's a new brand, Ghana. Like Jabong. Like for us, it's a Jabong is a new company, new brand, which we had never heard of. For South Africa, it's a flower. Tenth option is to use the country-specific extension very innovatively. Now, just see this. I'm sure you must have heard of this site called Delicious. Okay, it's a social bookmarking site. Yeah. Now, .us is an extension of USA. They registered ICIO. Okay, and then they created a DEL as a subdomain, which is free to them. And whole thing reads as delicious or domain. Somebody registered DOMA, DOMA, .in. Whole thing put together reads as domain. So, if you can be a little innovative and try to, of course, be wary about a country. So, like, .in, .ca stands for Canada, okay, or .eu stands for Europe, .my stands for Malaysia, .de stands for Germany. So try to use such countries, they are safe countries, or unki extension ko lekar, if you can create a word for yourself, okay, then it becomes a little innovative and interesting for people. Now, here, let me call Manish again. Manish, why FNP.com and why not Ferns and Petals, which your customers know better?
The easier to remember, the better it is. FNP, just three letter domain. We have paid a hell lot of money, by the way, to get that domain. And it's easy to remember and make it simple. Don't make it very lengthy. Don't make it just make it simple and relevant to your business. As simple as that.
Oh, got it. Okay. Now, when people create domain names, at times we have seen there are goof ups which has happened. Okay. So, I want to now share some of the goof ups, but please, guys, note, no offense is meant. please take it in a lighter vein. We all adult and matured people here. Okay. So there is no any ill intention. Idea is to only share with you some goof ups how people have created perhaps in a domain name. Perhaps I'm not saying it's a okay. So it's a something which should not be offending to you. Okay. And don't come and tell me outside, sir, ye sab kya aap dikha rahe ho sab. Okay. It's just to show you that how domain names can lead to some misunderstandings. What do you read as? The company name is Via Graphics. They have changed the name thereafter to Learn2. What does it read as? Company name is actually Mammoth Erection. But domain name, padke to aisa lagta nahi yaar kya sab. I mean, people who understand the meaning, they will know. Okay, it's something very dangerous to talk about. Just imagine if I had to tell, convey my domain to somebody, my domain is Mammoth Erection, domain.com. What does it read as? Auctionshit.com, right? Actually, it is auctionshit.com. But jab domain name koi padhta hai, toh kaise padhta hai? Mistake? I mean, you don't want your domain to be read that way, right? Some more. I have gas.com. No, not me, bhai. Don't look at me. Mere taraf mat dekho. But actually, it is IHA Vegas Holiday Rentals. Or, yeah, it looks like Odd Sex Tractor. It is actually Odds Extractor. Or AlterScrap.com. Now, you know what is scrap means, right? So, but it is AlterScrap. Okay. Now, that fourth one reads IPAnywhere.com. Okay, it is actually IP, in the sense internet protocol, okay, anywhere. But it reads like IP anywhere. Okay. Then, third one, buygirlsonline.com, BIGLS, buygirlsonline. Actually, it is big alls online, right? Or last one, Webone. Okay, actually, it is web one. Interesting goof ups, yeah. And this is what I cover in all my domain name lectures. We teach that. Don't goof up. I mean, whenever you create a domain name, please make 10, 20, 30 people read your domain name. And don't influence them. Let them read on their own and see what they read, okay, before you finalize a domain name. One of our past students is in tea business, doing very good business in tea. Offline, of course, traditionally. And now he wanted to go online. We create a group, WhatsApp group for every batch that we form. So like we have formed batch here, group here for this batch. Similarly, we have formed a batch for that group also. So after the course got over, after good 6, 8, 9 months later, one day this participant of our course sends a message on a group that, you know, I have launched this new web store, okay. And blah, 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 blah. My daughter, so she used to work for our company and she was the administrator of all this WhatsApp. She used to do the coordination job. Okay. So she saw the message in the group and she said, Dad, somebody has started a chappal business. Okay. So I said, Asha, dekha maine. I saw that domain name read as chappalace.com. Okay. So it read as chappalace.com. But because I know my students, so you know, I said, this is chappalace.com, chappalace nahi hai. Okay. So it was chappalace.com. Okay. But it was read by my daughter as chappalace.com because she was unaware of the product he was selling. I was aware, so I could read as a chappalace. So, galtiya hoti hai. Okay. Sikhane ke bawajood bhi galtiya hoti hai. Okay. So, kehne ka matlab hai, this is how it is. So, guys, my humble submission to all of you, tomorrow when you set up a domain name, please get it researched. You know, in part of, you know, we have done research and planning and where you have to go and talk to your customers. One of the things is going to be domain name. Not only from mistake point of view, but otherwise also how appealing the domain is for the customer, how easy it is to remember, how they pronounce it is something which you got to also check on with your prospective customers. People send to us, of course, I mean, send it to us, no problem. They'll give a long list, sir, ye 10 domain, please select for this, acha kaun sa hai. Best thing is the customer. वो कस्टमर को आप जाके 50 कस्टमर को पूछो ये 10 डोमेन में उसमें से कौन सा अच्छा है, एंड कस्टमर्स आर द राइट पर्सन टू सिलेक्ट, राइट? आई कैन गिव माई ओपिनियन तो मेरे को कौन सा पसंद आया, बट योर कस्टमर इज द राइट पर्सन टू गिव यू द राइट ओपिनियन. ओके, सो आस्क योर कस्टमर्स एंड चेक अ गुड डोमेन फॉर योर सेल्फ. ऑल राइट, सो या
माई कंपनी नेम इज वैली प्लस स्ट्रेटजी.
Yeah.
The website name is Valley Plus Strategy, but both we double A is there.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what is your name? Ashish sir, he told me why double A.
Yeah, numerology.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know that. So I'll tell you what. I never give opinion till I anything. Call up. Best thing is the customers. Okay. Ask, go and ask them, and they are the right people to tell you. Too long. खत्म हो गई ना बात. फिर आपका numerology बाढ़ में गया फिर. अगर कस्टमर बोलेगा टू लॉन्ग देन यू योर कस्टमर इज द फर्स्ट गाय टू रिमेंबर टू टेक योर ओपिनियन फ्रॉम नॉट अ न्यूमरोलॉजिस्ट. ओके, सो आई थिंक डोंट गो विद न्यूमरोलॉजी, गो विद व्हाट कस्टमर सेज.
वेयर टू फाइंड
डोमेन नेम,
फाइंड एंड बाय डोमेन नेम.
ओके, फाइंड एंड बाय. सो आई यूज गोडैडी, देयर आर क्वाइट अ फ्यू अदर वेबसाइट्स एंड नंबर ऑफ वेबसाइट व्हिच सेल्स डोमेन नेम्स. But personally, I've been using GoDaddy, and the one reason being, they have a superb service, extraordinarily good service, GoDaddy.com. Other thing is, let me quickly again show you something. So, what you can do is, many times, you know, you want a name. If you are looking for a particular domain, and you want to know who owns it, okay, so, any one domain, can you give me just one domain, anybody? Spell it please.
Doctor Hope.
Hope. Acha Hope. Okay. So www.doctor. Yeah. Hope.in. Right. Okay. Now immediately it says that this domain is registered to Tejas Khandelwal. Okay. 106 Suraj Bungalow Agarwal Nagar Dhule. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. This is the pin code. This is a phone number, okay, and domain is getting expired. Idhar gaya. 19 May 2017. So any domain name you can, if you are not getting a domain name, jo aapko chahiye, you can check on who is the owner of the domain, and maybe and try to do the one thing. Let's say I am looking for Dr. Hope. He has registered it, and I am looking for Dr. Hope. That domain. Dot in. So I'll put that domain name. In my browser, okay, and it says we are coming soon. Okay, ये तो है. Many times the domain name you'll see there is no page. लोग domain लेके रखते हैं and page नहीं. तो there is a possibility कि that means वो बंदा बेच सकता है अपना domain name क्योंकि उसका धंधा चल नहीं रहा अभी. I mean he is not put up anything. So in such case you have a hope, you can call that guy because you have the phone number. Call that guy and say that I want to buy a domain name and maybe he'll charge you something more extra or whatever. Buy it out if it's really important to have the domain name with you. Any other question? So I hope I have answered the question. GoDaddy is the one which I use. There are other. I'm not advocating GoDaddy, of course. Please don't take me wrong. I've been using GoDaddy. I found the service very good. You can try other people also, like Net for India and all those things. Any other questions? Take out the domain name.
Sir, this domain name normally our web designer he registers.
Ah, now that's a good point. That's a very good point. As far as possible, do not depend on anybody else to register your domain. You should be registering your own domain. Your address, phone number, everything should be your email ID especially, should be yours. When you ask somebody else to get a domain name registered, he is going to or she is going to put his or her address, email ID, phone number. When the domain is about to expire, that person will get an intimation, and if that person is not alert, he may or she may not come back to you saying ki yaar aapka domain expire ho raha hai, what do you want to do, do you want to renew it? And many people have suffered because of this. I am a member of BIA, that is Bombay Industries Association. I am a committee member, and I realized that BIA lost their domain name because their developer had registered few years ago. Aaj jo developer ke saath unke kuch pange hue hain, whatever, you know, and that developer has now, the domain is under his control. He is not cooperating, and BIA compulsory had to move on to completely new domain, which is a moving to a new location is a big challenge because you have to inform to the world the new location, new address. Okay. Recently, our own ISCB, IndianSchoolOfEBusiness.com, that's a domain which you own, registered by our one of our tech support companies. Okay. Long back. तभी उसको बोल देगा ये कर ले अर्जेंट में हम लोगों को चाहिए था तो he registered with his name, his email ID, he got an intimation, didn't inform us, our domain got expired. We had to pay 6,000 rupees extra to revive our domain back. हाँ यहाँ तो ask for, but best thing is कि आप ही register कर लो सब कुछ. And it's so easy to register. You don't need to do much, okay? You don't need to be a technically expert or savvy guy to register domain. It's simple steps.
But once it is done now, can you alter that?
Yeah, you can alter it. Yes. You can change it.
Provided it is available.
No. Agar aapka domain kisi aur ne liya hua hai aapke behalf pe, maliki to aapki hai na, so you can always ask him to...
Can we change the name of the domain?
No, domain name you cannot change. That's the...
Only if it is available.
But aapke jo registration ke jo details hai, login ke details hai, that you can change.
Done with the developer already, if
he
can get it back.
No, so, yeah, but domain belongs to him, right? That's his domain. Developer has bought it for on his behalf. So, guys, I hope you enjoy today's session. With this, we end our domain names module today here. And we are now going into the next module.